In this video, we are going to see about what is KPI in Power BI. KPI stands for Key Performance Indicator. It's a visual cue that communicates the amount of progress made towards your measurable goal. Basically, you will have defined some business goals and you are tracking that goal, whether you are on track or not. You're tracking the progress towards your goal. That is what a KPI stands for. When you need to use it, it is to measure the progress. As I said before, it should answer this question: what am I ahead or behind on? You set some goal, whether you are ahead of that goal or behind that goal. In other ways, it is to measure the distance to a goal. It is more or less same. It is you have goal or target, you are tracking it. So now in this case, you are tracking how far ahead or behind am I. So if you have a question like this, then you need to use KPI. If you're still confused, let us see with some example. We're exploring Power BI using Naga comments. And today he has a question like, will the company achieve its sales target this month? So he has set some sales target, that is 173,000, and he is trying to track whether he can achieve it or not. That is one of his KPI. He has another KPI, like he want to recruit 10 new employees by end of September 2020. So if he decides on today, say for example now it's August, and before September end he want to recruit 10 people, so he hardly got 1 month of time, so he needs to recruit 10 people. So the problem for him is to how he can manage. So after completing 10 days, September 10th, he should at least recruit 3 person. On September 20th, he should complete 6 persons, so that he can meet the target at the end of the September. So how we will see this one? We will take it this one later. I mean, give it for exercise. We will see this example to achieve his target, whether he is achieving his target or not using a KPI. Let's see it in a demo. We have a simple model here, like sales product master and dim date, and I have one target table. Let us quickly see the target table. We have it here. So the user Naga Garments business set a 3 months target, simple as that. The month December 2017, this is his target. So his target is remains same. Okay, now let us try to build. First we will try to see the data. So I have already built a MTD measure, that is sales MTD, so that it will cumulatively add each date. So let me put this one here, and I want to see the trend, right? And let me have this year over here, and you see we have 2 years data. Let us try to navigate till date, so that you can see the YTD value, I mean MTD value, each month on month. Let me filter out December. So you see like each day he's having his data. I mean every day it starts with MTD. You might have aware, like on first day it is 4,700, on second day it is 9,300, meaning the first day sales summed up with second day sales. That is what it is growing like this. So that it's like a progressive growth, right? Cumulative figures are shown like this only. So what I'm going to do, let me put the target over here. As these two are connected, date dimension, my target I set it on month end. So now I can see like on month end, he is not achieved his target, like 173 and 170 he has achieved. Let me zoom a little bit, a little bigger. Now you see the sales amount MTD is 170 and his target is 173. He didn't achieve his target. Doing like this will not give us immediate attention, right? So he wants to get immediate attention, should highlight that this whether he is achieving his target or not. That is the key performance indicator. Just it has to indicate whether you are achieving the target or not. That is can be achieved using a KPI. Now let me click on this KPI. What happened now? You quickly see it here. It indicates in red, right? So the goal is 17300, but he achieved 170250. So now he had not achieved his goal. Now you can see how it is formatted. My indicator is my whatever I want to track, and my target I have put it here, and the trend, it says this is the trend, there is some progress towards it. If I click on another month, this month also he didn't achieve his target, but when you see on October, it turns automatically to green. That's the magic. So as soon as he sees this report, earlier how he saw this report, it was like this, right? Seeing like this will not give him whether he is particular figure will not give him to understand whether he is towards his goal or not. But as soon as he sees this green figure, he can able to immediately identify whether he has achieved his goal or not. That is the key indicator purpose. So whether I need to use only this as a key performance indicator, no need. There is another option, Gantt chart also can be used as some of the things to highlight as a key performance indicator, but the requirement is little different here. So let me put MTD, sales amount MTD as my value, and my target I can put it in the target value. So now you can see here also it is more or less same, but it contains a minimum maximum value, where to start from, where to end from. Either you can bring it from in the table. Right now I'm giving it manually, like minimum and maximum. Let me put like 174,000 or maybe 6,000. Okay, so we are pretty much close. Let me put this. So just this is your end. It doesn't give any value. Your target is this. Let me go to December or November. See, now November it clearly indicates here for me to understand. Let me take a duplicate of this page. Okay, let me remove this. Let me put it here. What I'm trying to say here is like here also I will take day. Okay, let me remove this and put it here and put it as a hierarchy. Okay, now what I am trying to do here is, again I'm saying for December he is not achieved his target, right? On December 1st he set his target, on December 31st he has to achieve 173. But assume like you are at 1st of December, okay? Now his value is 470. Now at the middle of the week, after 10 days, he sees like his total sales is 54k on this month. It is cumulative, okay? And so he sees like another 20 days are there, so he can able to achieve his target, right? So now he can't able to see the target because there is no dates involved. So let me remove this one. It will be confusing for you guys to understand why I'm removing. It is disconnected now. Since I don't have data on 31st, the target is not set at the month level. I set it at the end of the month. That is why it's not showing. Okay. Now, let me put it here. Let me put and do it as a maximum. Okay. Now it appeared. Okay, that is because it summed up for all the dates. Okay, if you sum up these three dates, it will be more, so it exceeded this value. That is why it came out of it. Okay, now what I'm trying to achieve is, like, now you see here on 10th he sees like 54k, but he has to achieve 173k. It is exactly one third of it, less than one third of it, because one third will be around 60, means it's fine, but it is less than 60. So the days are one third of it. Out of 30 days, 10th day is one third. So you see, he can't able to achieve it. So he gets some alert now, like, we can't able to achieve this target. On 20th, he's saying, on 20th, still he is almost near, but he can't able to achieve it, right? So that is the thing, he can able to see it here. On 30th, he says he can't able to achieve. This is the trend. He can foresee it in before achieving the target, then he can see, like, he can able to achieve or not. Based on that, he can take some decisions. Example, like, now he is in 21st, he want to achieve the target, so he can promote some sales, right? I mean, he can give some offers so that the sales will boost and he can achieve the target. So it's not setting about a goal, and you can keep tracking it so that you can take some decisions. This is the main purpose of your key performance indicator, how to do it. There are different ways to do it, and one such indicator is this. It's a KPI visual, and just a gauge visual also can be used as a KPI visual. I hope you guys like this video. If you like this video, subscribe to the channel, and do remember that data is your asset.